something that I have been doing lately, sorry, is copying masters. And it's actually very logical to, because people always say it, and I think that's one of the main things that they teach in art school, is that you have to copy the masters. And I think the best, what you're learning from this is, they have mastered this art, and you love this piece. And if you copy it, and if you look real closely at the colors that they're using, and how the brush strokes are maybe laying out, then you can learn so much by just doing that. I'm trying to just talk without any script or something, so maybe be rambling a bit. But over here I'm just using some gouache and I don't even know who I'm painting, but I got this art book with a lot of studies by artists and how they drew the body. And this was one of them, and I just cut it out and I stuck it in, and now I'm just copying it. It's like a really good practice. Like, not only you draw a body, and I really want to improve anatomy drawings, but yeah, here's like a close-up shot so you can see. But not only are you copying a body, you can also copy other things, of course, doing that in a later video. But you're also learning how to use color and lighting and everything. I think this one was actually not from the painting, but from the sculpture. I really like to paint from the sculptures. So what I did for all these paintings was I just first lay down. Oh, I'm so sorry. English is not my first language. But first, put down a layer of gesso. My sketchbook is pretty heavy paper already, but the gesso just makes it just a bit more sturdy. And then I just try to put some color in. With this, I just really wanted to focus on lightning, so the easiest way to do that is to just use one color instead of try. I need to put so many colors down, which I normally do. Let's see. So, I think, here I got some more really bad studies actually. Some bodies, and the one I just shown on video, and another one. And over here I tried something different, a landscape study. And what I often see in these paintings is that they're like this underpainting or this base color. And this one I saw that was like a light yellow. And I really think you should look at that. But there's often these old paintings have this base color. And it actually also helps to make this painting more cohesive. Because especially with gouache, especially with gouache, if you put a color over an older color, it kind of picks it up and it just mixes again, which is sometimes real annoying, but it's also, you can like use it to your advantage to make this painting more cohesive, have it like, because if you have this base color which you mix the other colors with, it makes it just way, like it's one piece and it's not just, like pop-ups of these sailing boats, for instance. Yeah, I really like this piece actually to do it, it's very different. So I'm probably going to do lots more of these. I hope you do too, because it really does help. It gives you different ways to paint, and it's also really nice to just look at these really great master paintings. Really hope you like this video. I'm gonna say bye now again.